Good day, folks. I am starting the day, which is I'm designating as a writing day, and it is now 12:45, perfect timing, and I'm starting off with a Dunkin', and I'll tell you, my Dunkin' order is a caramel cold brew, but I went on the app. Pause. But I went on the app and I saw that there's a s'mores cold brew. Yeah, I'm gonna have to try that. A lot of times when I try a new thing, I don't like it. I don't end up liking it, and I just wish I had got my normal one. This one, however, is super good. I'm also gonna quick go through my writing day essentials / desk essentials before we get started on my actual stuff that I need and want to do. Something I'm learning / getting in the habit of is doing art stuff first, doing creative stuff first. So like when I'm coming home and I have some free hours, not spending the time doing my laundry when I can be doing my laundry a different day or a different time, when really the number one thing I need to be doing is not laundry, because I have clothes. I have clean clothes to wear. It's this, and I like to avoid it by doing like household things, just various things that I'm convincing myself are productive, and maybe they are helping in some way, like the house. But not actually furthering my goals. So that's what I'm working on. And then Amy McNee from @inspiredtowrite on Instagram. She also has a YouTube now. She always writes art first, muggle shit later. So that's what I'm practicing. It's hard to do. Okay, here's a quick run through of what I like to have on my desk when I'm writing. So first of all, I'm not always at my desk, but when I wanna be like really focus and intentional for a period of time, I'll come to my desk. I plug in my keyboard and mouse. Wait, where are you, buddy? I have usually a caffeinated drink, sometimes not. Usually, so a drink other than water, and then also water. Today, I have my planner with me. These are new planners. They are from Apartment 128. I will put her Instagram and website down below. I won a giveaway and got these, and these are the best things ever. So this is for if anything comes up, I will put it in here on this blank side, because you get a whole blank side every single day. I'll put it there. But I'm not doing like this kind of stuff right now, right? I'm not doing these kind of like send this person email, put in this maintenance request, buy this thing. I'm not doing that. These are two documents that I found are kind of like how I'm guiding the project of the UC Normal book. And one is the overview. So looks like that. I'm basically talking about, what is the overview of my book proposal? And it's basically keeping me on a certain track of like, this is what I'm trying to do. And this is what I'm trying to do, like purpose. And then this is how I'm doing it. So I'm making sure that stuff within the book actually aligns with this, because this is how I want it. The overview is like my ideal version, so I'm making sure stuff in the book actually aligns with it. So I have that printed off just so I can see stuff. And then I also have the author bio. I don't know why I printed this. I think I printed this because in this, I kind of convinced myself of credibility, which is not a degree in anything related to psychology or any like clinical experience, anything like that. But I talk about other things. And also in the sentence I said, a child of the internet, previously I have channels that have more than 200,000 views, 7,000 watch hours, and nearly 200 videos. I've made so many videos, I've posted so many videos on the internet. That's a different YouTube channel, you guys. You Seem Normal, I have like, how many do I have on You Seem Normal? I have 125 videos just on You Seem Normal. Let's just say, yeah, I'm kind of a child of the internet, and I kind of have made videos forever. Actually made videos when I was as young as like, what do I want to say, 10? 10, I would film them and I would edit them on Windows Movie Maker, and I had my own little digital camera and made with my cousins and my friends. It's all kinds of stuff, and it's pretty fun, and I do have some of it. And it's pretty good. I like it, I like it. Okay, back to the stuff I have in front of me. I have this notebook. This is if I need to jot stuff down related to the project and not necessarily in a digital way. I put it in here. Sometimes I don't even use this. This is kind of like my baby blanket. Like, I always want to have this little notebook with me. And yeah, I think that's everything. Usually I have a candle lit, but if there is a maintenance person coming, you're not supposed to have candles in here. So I'm not gonna risk that. Okay, let's get started. Okay, it is 3:30 now. I'm just wrapping up here. I worked on chapter outline of my book proposal, which basically means you go through and you write like 1 to 2 paragraphs about what every chapter is about. I don't consider my book to have chapters, but rather 3 sections. So I kind of had to make subsections as chapters. Otherwise, I would just be describing 3 sections, which are really chunky. And I don't think that'll fly, but who's to say? There might not be any rules. I know that there are rules and I'm trying to follow them. I am a rule follower. It's a beautiful day outside. I'm going to meet my friend for dinner tonight. So I have to go get ready for that. Okay, it's the next day. I've spent basically the whole day, first of all, reading a fiction book just for fun. And then secondly, doing a lot of research on the publishing houses and the specific agents that have worked on the books that are most like mine, that are in the market. And of course I found a book that I'm reading the title and I'm like, I came up with this exact title for my book while brainstorming. Has my book already been written? And I felt like this a lot. There have been other titles I think I've talked about that very much sound like something that I would write. So that's a little bit intimidating. It's interesting because I didn't get the name from them. It's just flowing in the same vein, and I'm reading the description and I'm like, wow, a lot of these things, same things are talked about, but then that just drives home the point of why you have to explain how yours is different than anything else that's on the market. So I almost feel like for my comp titles, I shouldn't make them too close to my book, or it's gonna be like, girl, it seems like that exists, but you also don't wanna be far off so that all you're doing is talking about differences. So that's where I'm at. I'm gonna take a break now because I've been on this couch all day. It's almost 5 p.m. I've been on this couch all day. Now I'm gonna go for a walk. Like, I want to go for a walk. It's weird. Anyway.